Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about a daily current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your MCQs from current affair perspective. So today is 2nd November, so let's see what are the questions for today. So the first question is, consider the following statements related to judicial power of the President of India. So there is a typing mistake here, there it must be judicial. First, the president is the only authority to pardon all the cases where the sentence is a sentence of death. Second, the pardoning power of the president is subject to judicial review process. So which of the above statements are correct? Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So president is the only authority in case of pardoning the cases of relating to the sentence of death, and this pardoning power is subject to judicial review. So this question has so the answer is C, both 1 and 2. So the question has been asked in the context of recent communication by Tihar Jail Administration to those who are the convicts of Nirbhaya case to apply for mercy petition before the president within 7 days, because all other legal options have been exhausted by the convicts. So you can find more reference about the judicial powers of the President of India under Article 72 of the Indian Constitution. So you can refer to the book Indian Polity by Lakshmikant for more details. So the question has been picked up from The Hindu. So the context is basically to give you an understanding that how UPSC frames questions. So you must not be just going into the detail of the news, but you must also look at how president can give pardon convicts, what are his or her pardoning powers, and what are the issues. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, the president can create or demolish the union territories under his or her executive power. Second, every union territory is administered by the president acting through an administrator appointed by him. So we have to choose the which of the above statements are correct. So let me tell you friends, first statement is clearly wrong. This is president cannot create or demolish these duties under his executive power. So first statement is clearly wrong. Second is though correct. This every union territory is administered by the president through an administrator appointed by him. So the answer is B, that is second only. So this question has been framed in the context of recent bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories, that is the union territory of Ladakh and Union Territory of J&K. So Radha Krishan Mathur has been appointed as first Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh, and Girish Chandra Murmu that of the Jammu and Kashmir. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following constitute highest weightage in 8 core sectors index? A, electricity generation. B, coal production. C, petroleum and refinery production. D, fertilizers. So friends, answer is C, that is petroleum and refinery production. So this question has been asked in the context of recent release of the data, in which it has been found that the core infrastructure industry output in the month of September has contracted by 5.2%. So this is concerning. So 8 core industries in the decreasing order of their weightage is refinery products, then comes your refinery products cover your petroleum as well, then electricity, then steel, then coal, then crude oil, then natural gas, then cement, then fertilizers. So petroleum and refinery has 28.40 of weightage, and then electricity generation is 19.85, then steel production is 17.92, coal production is 10.33, crude oil production is 8.98, natural gas production is 6.88%, then cement production is 5.37, and fertilizer production is 2.63. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, financial inclusion report seen in news is released by A, World Bank. B, Asian Development Bank. C, Economic Intelligence Unit, DIMF. So friends, answer is C, that is Economic Intelligence Unit. So according to Economic Intelligence Unit's 2019 report, basically on it is a report titled Global Microscope on Financial Inclusion Report. So India has been ranked at 5th position and is among the top nations with most conducive environment for financial inclusion. So this Global Microscope assesses the enabling environment for financial inclusion across 5 categories in 55 countries. So 5 categories are government and policy support, stability and integrity, products and outlets and consumer protection and infrastructure. So 2019 edition featured 11 new gender focused indicators that measure financial inclusion for both men and women. So it is Economic Intelligence Unit is a research and analysis division of the Economist Group, the sister company to the Economist newspaper. It has its office in London, UK. So RBI has also prepared a draft national strategy for financial exclusion to deepen financial services coverage in the country. So this is expected to be finalized in 2019 and will cover a 5-year period. And also a high level committee has been set up to review the existing status of digitization and devise a medium term strategy for increasing digital payments. In 2019, RBI also released enabling framework for regulatory sandbox, which created the basis for a regulatory sandbox that allows fintech startups to live test innovative products and services. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is Gothiprolu, an archaeological site, is in the state of A, Tamil Nadu, B, Karnataka, C, Kerala, D, Andhra Pradesh. So solution is D, that is Andhra Pradesh. So recently Archaeological Survey of India at Gothiprolu near Nellore, so now renamed as Shri Poti Shri Ramullu district, so it is basically in Andhra Pradesh. It has discovered the remains of a huge settlement. So it lies on the right bank of a distributary of river Swarnamukhi. So proximity of the site to Sea Coast suggests that the site could have served as a strategic settlement and involved in maritime trade. So detailed topographic graphical studies have identified an early historic settlement surrounded by a fortification and possibility of a moat encircling it. So various items have been excavated, like a life-size buried Vishnu sculpture with following specifications, that is four-armed Vishnu standing over a pedestal, carrying chakra and conch in his upper right and left hands respectively, and the lower right is in bestowing boon position and the left hand is in Katihasta, resting on the hip posture. That is features like elaborate headgear, thick holy thread, decorative drapery dates it back to the Pallava period. So pottery conical jars that are considered to be imitated variety of Roman amphorae jars, ancient Greek or Roman jar jug used to transport liquid commodities. So these settlements could have been an important trade center due to the presence of an imitated amphorae wares. So more things have been found. You can pause the video and can know more about it. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements is not included in the UNESCO's network of creative cities? A, Chennai, B, Jaipur, C, Delhi, D, Hyderabad. So answer is front C, Delhi. So solution is C. United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization has included Mumbai and Hyderabad in its network of creative cities among 66 cities selected on the occasion of World Cities Day 2019, 31st October. So Mumbai has been designated as creative city of the films and Hyderabad as the creative city of gastronomy. And then earlier Indian cities like Chennai, Varanasi have also been included in this UNESCO cities of music, while Jaipur has been included in the city of crafts and folk arts. So significance is basically the cities pledged to share best practices and develop partnerships including public and private to strengthen the creation, production and distribution of cultural activities. So UNESCO Creative Cities Network was created in 2004. So currently 180 cities make up this network. So it aims to at a common objective of placing creativity and cultural industries at the heart of their development plans. That is in the development plans of the cities. So UNESCO Creative Cities aims to achieve sustainable development goals also through innovative thinking and action. So SDG 11 aims for sustainable cities and communities, seven creative fields, network of seven creative fields, that is crafts and folk arts, media arts and film, design, gastronomy, literature and music. So World Cities Day is celebrated worldwide 31st of October. So theme this year was the changing the world, innovations and a better life for future generations. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, greater adjutant stock ID distributed only in the southern peninsula. It is listed as endangered in IUCN red list of threatened species. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is B, that is second only. It is not ID, it is EID. So in flow, sometimes mistake happens. So answer is B, second only. So context is an awesome adjutant strokes get a baby shower. So it is the world's most endangered endangered of stork species. So it was distributed throughout northern and eastern India earlier, but now and many countries also, so, they were present in many countries in South and Southeast Asia, but it is now limited to Assam, Bihar and a few other locations in Cambodia. So it has been listed endangered, and it is locally called Hargila in the Brahmaputra Valley in Assam, which harbors more than 80% of the global population of the species. So more video, more about this you can read by pausing the video. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, the proposed Mekadattu reservoir is to be built on river A, Kaveri, B, Mahanadi, C, Yamuna, D, Godavari. So friends, this question is quite easy. So Mekadattu reservoir is often in news. So the answer is A, Kaveri. So this reservoir project envisages building a balancing reservoir in Kaveri river with storage of 67,000 million cubic feet. So more you can read by pausing the video. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to national health profile. First, it is released by Central Bureau of Health Intelligence. Second, it covers only the health status and health finance indicator. So we have to choose which of the above statements is are correct. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is first. Second is not correct. So the answer is A. So basically, national health profile is released by Central Bureau of Health Intelligence, and it is not just doesn't cover just health status and health finance indicator, but it also covers various type of health clinics that are spread all over country. So it covers demographic, socioeconomic health status and health finance indicators, human resources in health sector, and the health infrastructure. So it is also an important source of information on various communicable and non-communicable diseases that are not covered under any major program. So India has registered an improved sex ratio from 933 in 2001 to 943 in 2011. So more details you can pause the video. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. Vyas Samman is given by Sahitya Akademi for an outstanding literary work in Hindi, authored by Indian citizen, published during the last 10 years. Second, Hindi writer Leeladhar Jaghuri was conferred this award for the year 2018. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So let me tell you friends, only one statement is correct, and that is first A. So Vyas Samman was started in 1991. It is given by KK Birla Foundation for an outstanding literary work in Hindi, authored by an Indian citizen. So authored by an Indian citizen, published during the last 10 years. So it carries an award money of rupees 4 lakh along with a citation and plaque. So Hindi writer Leeladhar Jaghuri was conferred this. So there is a mistake, friends. Yes, second is also correct. Leeladhar Jaghuri was conferred this award for the year 2018. So this is all about, friends, today's video. So its answer should be C, that is both 1 and 2. So this is all about today's video, friends. If you like this video, if you like the discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And lastly, friends, we also have a Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen. This link will also be provided in the description box. So more than 14,000 subscribers we have on this Telegram channel, which and you can also become part of these subscribers. And on this Telegram channel, what we do, we share various public resources that we have for the purpose of CSE preparation. So if in case you are interested to access those resources, then you can join our Telegram channel, and also you can visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, and then also you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com if you have any queries, and you can also contact us at 896892070 if you have any doubts, queries. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Do ensure that you check the description box and do ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.